in the conference. Game two of the series has been pushed back tonight. It will now start at 7 o'clock. That's even a little doubtful. There's rain in the area, thunderstorms all day. Fingers crossed we can get it in. If we start at 7, we'll have a 6:30 pregame show for you. Brendan Gurton versus Cole Klecker, a couple of hard-throwing right-handers, the pitching matchup tonight. Good news so far here in Fort Worth. Skip Johnson picks up his 200th victory on Friday night as the Sooners win game 1-7-3. Chris, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Toby. Jada Coleman watches as Patty Gasso walks behind home plate, takes her spot in the third base coach's box. Coach in her 30th season as the head coach of the University of Oklahoma. Coach Steele, Fall A Steele over at first. Jada Coleman digs in. Staring in is the righty Maddie Keel, and the first pitch of the game is a base hit back up the middle from Jada Coleman. Oklahoma wastes no time. A single back up the middle from Jada, and it's Ella Parker striding to the plate. First pitch, right on time at 1:03. When we arrived at the ballpark and the field wasn't tarped and it started pouring, there was some doubt that this might happen on time, but here we are. Wild pitch on the first pitch to Parker to the backstop. Off to second goes Coleman. I mean, it was pouring. I was watching Kylie Lundberg go out and take a look at the field. We were texting. I made the joke, it reminds me of 2016 Iowa State. That Sunday game was not fun. Coleman now at second. Here's the 1-0 pitch from Maddie Keel to Parker. It's high. So still got a lot of work to do from the pregame show. Today's game day weather is presented by the Trails Golf Club in Norman, where you'll experience everything you love about golf and more. 47 degrees. It's wet. Winds are out of the north at 9 miles an hour. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Bounced softly to the right side. It'll be a race to the back. Parker wins the race between her and Barnhart. First and third, nobody out. It's an infield single for Ella Parker on a slow roller to the right side. Back-to-back hits. Here's Cassidy Pickering. The good news is the rain appears to be out of the forecast for at least a window over the next 3 to 4 hours. Rain chances ratchet up just a bit overnight and into tomorrow morning. First pitch from Keel to Pickering shows bunt. Off to second goes Parker. An uncontested stolen base for Ella Parker. It's a little chilly, very overcast, not nearly as windy as it was yesterday. Here's the 1-0 pitch to Pickering with runners now at second and third, and it's outside. Today's game day weather presented by the Trails Golf Club in Norman. Experience everything you love about golf and more. And thanks for joining us for the Sooner pregame show presented by Walden Cleaners and Laundry, where the difference is quality. Second and third, nobody out. First, the 2-0 pitch is in for a strike. Starting pitcher, Maddie Keel, 7-3 on the season with a 2.27 ERA. This is her 10th start in 61 and two-thirds of an inning. Struck out 56, walked 29. 2-1 is in for strike two. Of her 22 runs are earned. The 2-2 pitch, well, that's a really good spot. Ball three. A little bit out, though. Here's what's bad is now I have people that can really judge me when I'm bad and mad at the umpires here in the booth. I don't like to have common sense in here. I don't. Here's the 3-2 pitch to Pickering, headed home. Fouls it off. Maddie Keel, righty, is a junior. She's out of Longmont, Colorado. Sooners have seen her before. She pitched against them last year. The 3-2. Up and in, ball four, bases loaded. Last night, Oklahoma drew 13 walks. There's the first walk of the game today. And the bases are loaded for the hottest hitter in college softball, Sid Sanders. Here's the first pitch from the righty to the righty. It's low and in, ball one. Bases are loaded, top of the first inning. The Sooners have come out hot. Here comes the 1-0 pitch to the Sooner first baseman. Keel brings it home. Right in there for strike one. Keel pitched in two of the three games against the Sooners last year. And she gave up four earned runs in an inning as the 1-1 pitch is high, 2-1. It's kind of wild. She pitched, made two appearances in the series against Oklahoma, and then didn't make an appearance regularly the rest of the year. Here's the 2-1. Sanders loops this one into shallow right field. Falling fast, it's down for a hit. Jada Coleman scores. It's 1-0 Sooners on an RBI single by Sid Sanders. A little blooper into shallow right field. It's 1-0 Sooners.
Now batting for the Sooners, number 23, T.R.A. James.
And here's T.R.A. The April 6th game, an inning, one hit, one run. Then on April 7th, didn't even last an inning. Gave up three earned runs. Here's the first pitch with the bases loaded to T.R.A. Jennings. It's up high. T.R.A. Jennings has now hit seven career home runs against Texas Tech. She bats here with the bases loaded and nobody out. The 1-0 took a little off it, dropped in for a strike. Sanders at first, Pickering at second, Parker at third. 1-0 Sooners, the 1-1. Line drive, deep to left field. It takes a hop and hits off the wall. Here comes Parker. Rounding third and scoring is Pickering. It's a two-run double from T.R.A. Jennings. Stay hot, T.R.A. It's 3-0 Sooners. And that tizer, T.R.A. Jennings is now tied with Sid Romero for the career Sooner record for most doubles. Sanders now at third. Oklahoma has come out swinging today. And here's Alyssa Brito. The first pitch to the Sooner third baseman is low and in, ball one. For T.R.A., that also ups her number to 33 career runs batted in. RBI on the season. Here's the 1-0. Off speed, hangs up high. Nice job by Wyckoff behind the plate to go up and get it. Two balls and no strikes. 3-0 Sooners. What a start. The pitch way outside to Brito. Ball three. I don't know how I didn't notice this, that Wyckoff is a left-handed catcher when she caught all night last night. Oh, they rotated her. Okay. 3-0, ball four. All right, that really scared me for a moment when I saw her listed as the catcher last night. Ryan, I was going to have to call somebody after the game. Yeah, they had her listed in the catcher in the final stats, and I'm like, I didn't have her as my catcher last night. There's a good reason why. Bases are loaded. We're going to have a trip to the circle here to try to calm things down for Maddie Keel from Bryce Tecolve, pitching coach in his first year out of Florida State. We mentioned we can catch up on a few things. Riverwind Casino keys the game. Listen, if they were the keys for Patty Gasso last night, we'll go with them again today. Eliminate walks. The wind isn't quite as big of a factor as it was last night or even during batting practice on Thursday night. Eliminate walks. and cashing in on RBI opportunities like the Sooners have done here early. Today's Keys to the Game brought to you by Riverwind Casino. Always a good time. Trip to the circle, complete. Brito at first. Jennings at second, Sanders at third. Boy, what a night last night. What a run it's been recently for the Sooner catcher, Riley Ludlam. First pitch with the bases loaded is a little bit low and in for ball one. Ludlam last night went 0 for 1 with a run scored. But she walked three times. This after going 3 for 3 in game two against Tarleton State. The 1-0 hangs up high, ball two. Brito at first, Jennings at second, Sanders at third. Bases loaded. Nobody out. A 2-0 count to Ludlam. Big hitters count here. The pitch. A little low, ball three. Riley Ludlam hitting 412 this season with runners in scoring position. The 3-0. Inside corner, strike one. Not to try to give one of my favorite places on the planet, the Trails Golf Club, any more love, but it is still misting and raining during this game. 3-1 is all four. A bases loaded walk to Riley Ludlam makes it 4-0 Sooners. Orrick walks in from shortstop. She can't believe it. She thought it was at the least. Strike two.
Adding for the Sooners, number 82.
The bases stay loaded. On the third walk of the inning. And here's Avery Hodge getting the start at second base. Righty-lefty matchup here. The lefty Hodge waits. The first pitch from Keel is in for a strike. This is the 11th start of the season for Avery Hodge. Looking for her first, I think this might be her first plate appearance with the bases loaded. 280 season average. 286 with runners in scoring position. She takes the 0-1 low and away, a ball and a strike. Sooners have put four on the board here in the top of the first inning, and the bases are still loaded with nobody out. Here comes the 1-1 pitch. Hodge rips it over the head of the second baseman Jennings into right field. Tiare Jennings scores. It's an RBI single from Avery Hodge. And it's 5-0 Oklahoma, and the bases are still loaded. Hodge just muscled that one into right field for her fifth run batted in of the season. And here's Riley Boone. We talked a lot about Riley Boone in the pregame conversation with Coach Gasso. Her awesome family. Shouts out to Gayla, and if Trevor's playing today, maybe he's getting a chance to listen. Here's the first pitch to Riley. It's in for a strike. Boone last night got a hit. She went 1-for-4 with a run scored. Season average at 4.06 for the Owosso product. The 0-1 is pop foul. I've learned something about Riley Boone this week. I always talk about Owosso, Owosso, Owosso. She started playing and started her schooling at Edison. She was an Edison Eagle before she moved on and played for the Rams of Owosso. Now, I don't know. I'll have to double-check with Gayla if she was there long enough to be a freshman or not. The 0-2 grounded down the third baseline, just foul. But high praise from Coach Gasso. It's been cool. We're working on a feature for Boyd Street Magazine on Riley Boone, and I feel like I've talked to just about everyone about Riley except Riley. She has a very busy schedule. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Boone bounces it to the left side. Through! Into left field. Brito scores. Everyone moves up 60. And Oklahoma is up 6-0 in the top of the first inning on an RBI single from Riley Boone through the left side of the infield. It's like a conga line. Everyone's just moving up 60 feet after every at bat.
Adding for the Sooners.
And Jada Coleman is the 10th batter to come to the plate, and she will face a new pitcher. Oklahoma chases Maddie Keel in the first inning as they bat around. The bases are loaded. Nobody is out, and it's 6-0 Sooners. So the new pitcher, they're going to the pen for Mimi Blackledge. I didn't mean to say inquisitively, but I didn't have her on my list of potential pitchers we might see today. I should have. She's only made 3 appearances so far. So the new pitcher, they're going to the pen for Mimi Blackledge. I didn't mean to say inquisitively, but I didn't have her on my list of potential pitchers we might see today. I should have. She's only made 3 appearances so far this year, a 3.82 ERA for Blackledge. 3 2/3 of an inning is all she's pitched in 2024. She's allowed 2 hits, 2 runs, both of them earned, has walked 5 and struck out 1. Opponents are hitting 167 against her. And no big deal, you're inheriting the bases loaded with nobody out, and Jada Coleman is headed to the plate. Sooner freshman since Jada Coleman stole 20 bases in 2021. And Tiare Jennings with that double earlier this inning has tied Sid Romero for the career doubles record with 58 career doubles. Still, wow. Here we go. Righty-lefty matchup. First pitch from Mimi Blackledge to Jada Coleman is low for ball one. That's the only change that Texas Tech will make, is Blackledge in the circle. Keel can re-enter. The 1-0, a little bit up high, 2-0. Jada hit the first pitch she saw from Keel back up the middle for a leadoff single. And she takes ball 3. None of these are relatively close. A 3-ball, no strike pitch is ball 4, and it's 7-0 Sooners on a bases loaded walk to Jada Coleman.
Now that'll score Ludlam. Number 5, Ella Parker.
And keep them loaded for Ella Parker. Just hit one out of the yard, Ella. First pitch is in for a strike. Parker singled, stole a base. Again, that stolen base for Parker was her 7th of the season, tied for the team lead. Here's the 0-1 with the sacks juiced. Ah, she tried to stop her swing, couldn't. Let's just say the miles per hour are not what the Sooners might be used to. That was only 55 miles an hour. Here comes the 0-2 pitch to Parker. Gets a piece of it, fouls it away, stays alive. Tolson Tax Resolution and Accounting wants to give you the inside scoop on what we're going to get from Texas Tech today. And the Red Raiders, they had some fight in them last night, but it seemed at the bottom of the 6th inning with nobody out and the bases loaded, kind of took the fight out of them whenever Kelly Maxwell struck out the side. The Sooners put 8 on the board in the 7th. The 0-2 is lined back up the middle and through into center field, a base hit. Hodge will score. Here comes Boone. She'll slide in safely. It's a 2-run single from Ella Parker. Hello, run rule territory in the top of the 1st inning with nobody out. It's 9-0. Chalk up the RBI numbers for Ella Parker to 24. Here's Cassidy Pickering, first and second. Still nobody out. First pitch, Pickering is high for ball one. Cassidy walked her last time up. One of three walks the Sooners have drawn so far. Here comes the 1-0 pitch. Foul back. Now no one wants to make an out. You don't want to be the person that makes an out. It's a good point. Thomas points out Mimi Black, which hasn't pitched a lot. The scoreboard lists her as an infielder. The 1-1 pitch drops a little bit low. Ball two. Pretty good take by Pickering there, though that was a pretty good-looking pitch as well. Two balls and a strike. Pickering waits, first and second. Nobody out. The pitch is lifted pretty deep to right center field, and that ball is long gone. A three-run home run from Cassidy Pickering. And Oklahoma has opened up a 12-zip first-inning lead with nobody out. Unbelievable. The Sooners have been shot out of a cannon today, and Pickering lost one over the right center field wall for her fourth home run of the season. Home runs this year are brought to you by the hardworking people of Oklahoma Oil and Natural Gas. They're getting their money's worth.
The Sooners, number one, Sydney Sanders.
First home run of the day for Oklahoma. After they hit four last night. Here's Sid Sanders, first pitch. A little bit low, ball one. One ball and one strike. The pitch to Sanders is popped up to right field. This will be the first out of the game. Elder makes the catch. And there's one away. A bit of a Bronx cheer from some of the fans here. I don't know about you guys. My team's down 12-0 in the top of the first inning. If I'm Craig Snyder, I might just get tossed from this game. Go home, watch it from the warmth of your own couch. Here's T.R.A., first pitch. A little bit low, ball one. Be aware of where the zone isn't today. Robert Gonzalez hasn't necessarily been giving that lower edge of the strike zone so far. Here's the 1-0. Check swing on another pitch, low, ball two. That looked pretty good from our vantage point. That mist and rain is constant. Two balls and no strikes. The pitch, Jennings takes it a little bit up, ball three. Jennings doubled and drove in two runs earlier this inning. Here's the 3-0, ball four. This is the 15th batter to come to the plate for the Sooners this inning.
Batting for the Sooners, number 33, Alyssa Brito.
Brito walked and scored earlier this inning. I keep wanting to say in the first. We're still in the first. Here's the first pitch to Brito. It's outside, ball one. Oklahoma went 22 minutes of actual game time without an out. The 1-0. Check swing on a pitch that dropped in for a strike. Texas Tech was finally able to register its first out of the inning after giving up 12 runs on 8 hits. And the Sooners have only hit one home run. The 1-1 is grounded back up the middle. Cut off, though, by Oryx. Steps on the back for one to first. They turned it. 6-3, double play, and the inning is over. But what an inning it was. Oklahoma heads to the bottom of the first inning with a 12-0 lead. 12 runs on 8 hits. Oh, wow, what a start. We head to the bottom of the first inning. It's 12-0 Sooners. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. 12-0 Sooners Here's Kirsten Buehler, Love's Travel Stops player to watch today. First pitch popped up, shallow left field, foul territory, racing over. Is T.R.A. Jennings to make the catch? One pitch, one out. Great job by Jennings in foul territory. Kirsten Deal has not allowed a run in Big 12 play in her career. This season, this is her, well, her ERA is at 0.85. This is her seventh start, eighth appearance. She's 5-0 with a 0.85 ERA in the first pitch swinging for Ariana Villa is fouled off for strike one. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. We probably didn't expect a 12-run first, but here we are. So congrats to Kirsten Deal finding herself in that spotlight with run support like any pitcher would dream of right now. Here's the 0-1 pitch. A little bit out. Villa on the season, a 3.68 average. Last night, she went 0-for-2 but did walk once. One of four Kelly Maxwell walks. The 1-1 pitch from Deal. That got away from her, a little bit away. Two balls and a strike. Some notes from that first half inning. 22 minutes without an out. We tally the whole first inning at 30 minutes. And that could be debated. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Lefty-lefty matchup is hit pretty deep to right field at the wall. Pickering goes up, and it's gone. It looked like Pickering might have been able to make a play on it. But Bubba Ewald is out there in right field, and he rules it a home run. It just got off the glove of Pickering. And even though the wind isn't blowing incredibly strong out to right field, there's still a bit of a jet stream, and Villa found it, and it's the first regular season run that Texas Tech has scored on Oklahoma since 2019. 12-1 Sooners. First pitch swinging for Riley Love, fouls it off, strike one. That's also the first run that Kirsten Deal has given up in Big 12 play in her career. Only the fifth run that she's allowed this season. No balls and a strike with one out in the bottom of the first inning. Oh, that hitter kind of came in a little bit too high. Love wears it. And the catcher, Kaylee Wyckoff, will stride to the plate. Most of the action in the Big 12 is, I should say, a large percentage of the action in the Big 12 is done for the day, and it's about to be done for the weekend in Ames. Iowa State won the first two games 9-1 and 9-4 to win the series, but Houston has struck back in a big way. They've got a 10-2 lead in the bottom of the fourth inning. Baylor in Kansas, Lawrence, first pitch is set for 2 o'clock. Oklahoma State and UCF, 2 o'clock as well. Home teams won both of those games last night. Texas already done for the weekend as they swept BYU in a game that had a doubleheader on Friday. Kaylee Wyckoff digs in after the hit by pitch. First pitch from Deal is a little bit out, ball one. Scores from around the Big 12 brought to you by Air Comfort Solutions, your total home solution for plumbing, heating, air conditioning, and electrical. Make the winning call today. Deal spinning that ball on her left hip. She brings home the 1-0. Swing and a miss. Took something off it. Wyckoff drilled herself into the ground. Wyckoff was 0-for-1 with a walk last night. Here's the 1-1. That missed a little bit up. Two balls and one strike. Here's the 2-1 pitch with a runner at first and one out. Bounce to the right side. Hodge charges it. Gets it on the short hop to second for one. Looked like Avery juggled just a bit getting it out of her glove. It would have been tough to get Wyckoff at first anyway, two away. And give credit to Avery Hodge. She didn't charge the high hopper. She played that second hop.
Now batting for the Red Raiders.
Kind of caught right in between hops. And with two away, here's Demi Elder, the right fielder. First pitch to Elder. She kind of turns into it, but the pitch is right on the inside corner for strike one. Elder Jr. out of League City, Texas, by way of Clear Springs High School. Waits on the 0-1 pitch. That's way up and away. One ball, one strike. Talked about the winds being a little bit less impactful today than they were yesterday, or even especially on Thursday when the team first arrived. They're starting to kick up just a bit here in West Texas. Here's the 1-1. That's lined to center field. Jada Coleman, though, has a beat on it. Makes the catch, and the inning is over. But Texas Tech gets its first run of the weekend, and Kirsten Deal gives up her first run ever in Big 12 play. As we head to the second inning, it's all Sooners. Oklahoma 12, Texas Tech 1. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. 12-1, the Sooners lead it as we head to the second inning. It'll be Ludlam, Hodge, and Boone. And back to work for Mimi Blackledge, the righty. Temperature feels like it's dropping. First pitch skips in for ball one. Ludlam walked and scored a run in the first inning. Every Sooner has scored a run. I mean, wow. 15 batters went to the plate in the first inning. The 1-0 pitch is in for a strike. The Sooners didn't make an out until after they had batted around. 22 clock minutes, only one pitching change in there before Tech registered it out. The 1-1 pitch is in for a strike, 1-2. Saying that's pretty good. One ball and two strikes. Pitch, Ludlam takes it low and away, ball two. Say it's going to warm up a little bit this afternoon. It's at 47 right now. Feels like 43. Says it'll reach a high of 50. The 2-2 misses outside. Probably should have been a called strike three. Full count. I mean, credit Tech for having this energy down 12-1. I mean, it's borderline impressive. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Grounded foul down the first base side. Now, Ludlam was probably guilty of swinging at ball four there, but I don't blame him. The storm system that pushed through Lubbock has moved on towards Oklahoma City, and fortunately Fort Worth. The 3-2 is ball four. That was up high. Ludlam with her fifth walk of the weekend. She stands at first, and here's Avery Hodge. Hodge had an RBI single in the first.
Batting for the Sooners, number 82, Avery Hodge.
Open stance from Hodge, shows bunt, pulls it back, takes the ball high. Winds have started away. Our winds are having the flags in center field wave towards that right field wall. State flag of Texas and the Texas Tech flag flank the American flag as the 1-0 pitch is high, ball two. Mist continues. Lights are on. There's activity in the Texas bullpen, Texas Tech bullpen. 2-0 is grounded foul on the first baseline. There's a little activity, too, in the Sooner pin. Peyton Monticelli is over getting warmed up. I'm sure we'll potentially see Nicole May, if not today, then for tomorrow's scheduled game. The 2-1. Line drive. What a beautiful leaping catch. It's short by Oryk, who throws behind Ludlam to double her off. Hodge hit a ball that looked destined to left center field. Oryk went up and got it, and then doubled off Ludlam at first. That was sensational. Two-way.
Now batting for the Sooners, number zero, Riley.
Here's Riley Boone. Chance of Boone as she rips one through into right field to base hit. A two-hit day for Riley Boone. And Oklahoma will turn the lineup over. Here's Jada Coleman. They are, as you might imagine here, constantly swapping out the softball. Towels are a premium. Coleman has already batted twice. We're in the top of the second inning. It's 12-1. First pitch low and away, ball one. Jada singled on the first pitch of the game and then walked. The 1-0 is fouled straight back. She's one for one, has scored two runs, and that walk came with the bases loaded to give her a run batted in. One ball and one strike. Coleman waits the pitch. That was nice, but a miss. Ball off speed just dropped right off the shelf, but might have started a little bit too high. Two balls and a strike. Jada Coleman sitting over 300 with two outs. That won't change as she, or that will change as she grounds it to the right side. Jennings, the second baseman, is up with it, throws, gets her inning over. So the Sooners strand a base runner for the first time today. As we head to the bottom of the second inning, it's 12-1 Sooners. 12-1 Sooners, first pitch in the bottom of the second inning. A line drive by Jennings dumped into center field for a base hit. Reagan Jennings, the second baseman for Texas Tech, leads off the second inning. With just the second hit of the game for Tech, Sooners have nine hits. It's 12-1 Oklahoma. Kirsten Deal rifles the ball into her glove in frustration. Let that pitch a little bit up. Jennings made her pay. And for Reagan Jennings, her second hit of the weekend. She was one for three last night. First pitch to Abby Oryk is in for a strike. Oryk went 0 for 2 with a walk last night for Texas Tech. A senior season average hovering around 300. She's at 293. Here comes an 0-1 pitch from the Sooner sophomore Kirsten Deal. That's a little humpback liner. One hop to Hodge. Shovels to Jennings for one to first. Oh, they say safe.
Freeze.
That ball was... It just died when it hit the dirt. And Hodge charged it. It was a beautiful turn, but Oryk just beat
Red Raiders, number 12, Maddie Wright.
And here's the DH, Maddie Wright, with a runner at first and one away. Maddie pitched here last night. And the first pitch is low and away for ball one. Three innings, gave up five runs, walked five. She didn't hit and took the loss. Here's the 1-0 pitch. That's a little bit out. Two balls and no strikes. Even with the bag at first, that's Sid Sanders. Couple steps back off the line is Brito at third. Straight up in center and right field and left field as the 2-0 pitch is fouled back. Couple good innings last night for Maddie Wright, the Charlotte transfer. She's ahead here 2-1. The pitch fouled straight back. Career 320 batting average includes her time at Charlotte. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Up high, full count. So far this year, she has not had a ton of opportunities. She's just 4-for-9, but that average looks good. 444, the full count pitch. Missed up high. Oh, called strike three! Called strike three! As Maddie Wright started walking down to first base, the home plate umpire ripped his mask off and made the strike call. Huh. Like I said, if I was Craig Snyder, I'd get thrown out of this game. Are they saying she swung? I guess so.
Logan Holloman.
Because it sure didn't look like it. Well, we'll take it. First strikeout of the game for Kirsten Deal. Here's the first pitch to Logan Holloman, and that's in for a strike. The Sooner infield draws in for the speedy Holloman. She's hitting .389 on the season and is 14-for-14 in her stolen base opportunities. Riley Ludlam made a great play off a punt she laid down last night. The 0-1 is fouled off, and quickly she's behind on the count is Holloman. No balls and two strikes. Nine-hole hitter, this would be the first time that the nine-hole hitter gets in a bat here in the bottom of the second inning. The Sooners nine-hole hitter already has hit twice. The 0-2. Boy, that's a good spot for an 0-2 pitch. Little wide, one ball, two strikes. I mentioned they have Maddie Wright struck out looking. That's one of the most delayed strikeout calls I've ever seen in my life. The 1-2 pitch is low, two balls and two strikes. In these conditions, Kirsten Deal only sporting an extra white undershirt. Not too many aren't sporting it today for the Sooners. Here's the 2-2 to Holloman. Ground to the right side, right to Sanders on a big hop. Takes it to the bag, inning over. There you go, Kirsten Deal. Works around the leadoff single. And as we head to the third, Oklahoma leads it 12-1. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Brought to you by Century Roofing. CenturyRoofingOK.com. Century Roofing on guard for Oklahoma. First pitch to Ella Parker is in for a strike. Parker's 2-for-2. Has a stolen base. Has driven in a couple of runs already. The 0-1. Little bit out. One ball and one strike. First in today at OU on the air. Sooner Judy, Silver City, New Mexico. 1-1 to Parker, drops in for strike two. She's been pretty consistent this year, I gotta tell you, Judy. Season average up to .458 for Parker. The 1-2 pitch reaches and bounces it to short. A couple steps back, the throw across gets her. Pretty good start over at shortstop for Abby Orrick. There's one away. First time the Sooners haven't had the leadoff hitter aboard. In fact, I just naturally put single in my book, 6-3. Here's Pickering. Homered her last time up. First pitch, she swings and drills this one deep to center field at the wall. It's caught. Holloman with her right hand on the wall makes the catch for the second out of the inning. Heard in our pregame show from Cassidy's grandparents. They're tuned in Willow Creek today, sunny Willow Creek today. We could take some sunlight here. Sooners trying to avoid going three up and three down as the first pitch to Sid Sanders is low for ball one. 12 runs for the Sooners, all of them in the first inning. Sanders single drove in a run and flied out to right. Here's the one ball, no strike pitch to Sanders. Ooh, she takes strike one. Mimi Blacklich has been okay in slowing down the bleeding for the Sooners so far. 2 2/3, 3 hits, 3 runs. Here's the 1-1 pitch to Sanders. Swings and fouls it down the third baseline. Joel's in Rogersville, Sharice down in Austin. Hey, Bruce Burdett and the entire OU Club of Birmingham crew tuned in today. Thank you, Bruce. Boomer Sooner all, y'all. The 1-2 reaches, hits it hard at third off a hop via our Love goes down, makes the play, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Aubrey Barnhart leads things off in the third for Texas Tech. First pitch swinging, popped up, shallow center field. Jada Coleman races in, make the catch. One pitch, one out in the third. Brought to you by Century Roofing, on guard for Oklahoma. 12-1, the Sooners lead it. I see our buddy Zane, Jan, and everyone tuning in to North Huntington, Pennsylvania. Troy and Cheryl are synced up in Norman. Lees are in Cedar Park, Texas. Connie Ogle in Norman. McKinley family from Houston, Missouri. Left-handed hitting Ariana Villa. Swings and fouls the first pitch back. Gotcha in El Reno. That's where Annette's tuned in. Rick and Yogi in Nashville. There's Kenyatta and his crew checking in. Starless Sadie in from the couch in front of the fire. Now, I'm envious of that. Toby and Diana, Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Here's the 0-1 pitch to the left-handed hitting Villa. That just missed out. Ariana Villa homered her last time up. That's the only run for Texas Tech today. It's 12-1 Sooners. But, you know, Coach Gasso is not going to be happy that the Sooners didn't put a run up in the second and the third. Hard to complain, though, after a 12-run first. Here's the 1-1 grounded foul. Craig Snyder can't make the play with his foot. Same defensive nine for the Sooners. Boone out in left, Coleman in center, Pickering in right. Sanders at first, Avery Hodge at second, Tiari Jennings at short, and Alyssa Brito at third, the battery of Beal and Ludlam. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Boy, that's a really good spot. That just missed outside, 2-2. Kirsten Deal is not missing by much. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Love waits on deck. The lefty-lefty matchup. The pitch. High chopper towards second. Hodge charges this one. Gloves it, throws to first. There are quickly two away. Riley Love was hit by a pitcher last time up. Nicholas is in OKC. Blakely family's checking in from OKC. Liz Nevitt listening in while watching from Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Hardley family's in Lutherville, Maryland. Sharon Walker has it synced up in Spring, Texas. Here's Riley Love. Lefty-righty matchup. First pitch fouled past the third base coach's box. If you weren't with us last night, they redid a lot of things here at Rocky Johnson Field. New turf outfield. New black padding around the outfield wall and behind the backstop. The Sooners are responsible for 4 of the top 7 crowds here in Texas Tech history. Here's the 0-1. Up high. We were joking. The Texas Tech people that were here were having a good smile. There was a line of people waiting to get in yesterday. They're like, there's people out there in line waiting. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Low, 2-1. Of course, it was ridiculously early. It's not to insinuate that people don't line up to come to Texas Tech softball games. I think they were surprised by how early Sooner fans had shown up. A 2-ball, 1-strike pitch. As Riley Love waits, Kirsten Deal brings it home. This ball is popped foul down the left field line. Is there room for Brito? No. I just heard from the man who calls Lubbock home, our good buddy Jeff Haxton. His father-in-law, Mike, is from Duncan. Mike Lewis is listening in Lubbock. So the in-laws are in town, Haxton, and they make you listen to me? Oh, dude, I am so sorry. 12-1, though. The Sooners are rolling here. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Love swings and pops it up to left field. Riley Boone under it, makes the catch, and a quick third inning all around for the Sooners and the Red Raiders. So Community Coffee, Taco Mayo, Boomerang Diner, Schwab Meat, and Uber Eats. 12-1 Sooners as we head to the fourth. The first pitch to Tiari Jennings is low and away, ball one. Brooke has checked in. Larissa just landed in Tampa after delayed flight. Hi, Mom. Her and Ellie Beecham tuned in today. A 1-0 pitch is in for a strike, 1-1. Appreciate everyone tuned in all across the country for Sooner softball. A 12-run first took any of the drama out of this. And Jennings rips this one to left field. It falls in for a hit. Tiara Jennings is now 2-for-2 on the day. Another multi-hit game. What a weekend for Jennings. Last night, Tiara went 3-for-3 with 6 runs batted in and 2 home runs. Today, she's 2-for-2. So 5-for-5 on the weekend for Tiara Jennings. And she's hit 7 career home runs against Texas Tech. Alina Torres will hit here for Alyssa Brito.
Number 40, Alina Torres.
Alina Torres has had a nice 2024 so far. First pitch swinging, bounces it to third. Backing up on it, making a nice play and gloving to get Torres at first. Is Love over at third, one away. Riley Love gets the start at third today. Last night, they went with the freshman over at third base, McKenna Mitchell, but Mitchell's been struggling at the plate, so Craig Snyder decides to put the vet over at third, and she makes the play. Jennings advances to second with one away. Here's Ludlum. Ludlum's walked twice, and the first pitch is low from Blackledge for ball one. Jennings, in her career against Texas Tech, is hitting .588. She stands at second and watches as Ludlum takes ball two. 20 of 34 with 7 home runs and 19 runs batted in against Texas Tech. I'll be happy to see her graduate. 2-0 is popped into shallow right field. Elder chasing it towards the line, makes the catch. Jennings fakes going. There's two away for Avery Hodge. Looks like Maya Bland has moved into the on-deck circle.
Batting for the Sooners, number 82, Avery Hodge.
I see Riley's already got the puffy coat on, so she's got to be happy. 2-for-2 night with an RBI and a run score. But for now, it's Hodge's show, and the first pitch is in for a strike. Avery Hodge is 1-for-2 with an RBI single, a run scored, and a line drive out on an amazing play made by Abby Orrick at short, who climbed the ladder and took away a base hit. The 0-1 pitch, this one's hit pretty well to left field. Racing over towards the line and making the catch is Villa. And the Sooners go scoreless again in the fourth. A couple of defensive changes for the Sooners. I just thought Riley Boone's day was done. She's out in right field. Hannah Core has come into play left. And Alina Torres stays in the game to play third. Kaylee Wyckoff leads things off. Lefty-lefty matchup. First pitch from Kirsten Deal. Strike one. Sooners up 12-1. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning. 12 runs on 10 hits for the Sooners. All the action in this game came in the first inning. The 0-1 pitch. A little bit low. One ball, one strike. Shouts out to our buddy Mark Montgomery, tuned in from rainy and snowy Santa Fe. Lisa Jean, Tulsa, Val and Jay and Norman, Mark Worley. Appreciate you guys making us a part of your Saturday afternoon. 1-1. This ball's hit pretty deep to right field. Riley Boone turns and watches it fly out of here. 12-2 on a home run from Kaylee Wyckoff. now bring Jimmy Elder to the plate. At the Trails Golf Club in Norman, you'll experience everything you love about golf and more. Learn about spring membership specials and the advantages of belonging to a private club by scheduling a private tour today. Visit trailsgolf.com. And located just minutes from the OU campus, the Courtyard by Marriott Norman is competitively priced with travelers in mind. Learn more about our great amenities and book your stay today at marriott.com/OKCNO. There's Demi Elder, first pitch in for a strike. For Texas Tech with their two home runs today for the Red Raiders. The 0-1 pitch is headed home. That ball's hit pretty well to center field and deep. Coleman races back, though, has a beat on it. Makes the catch at the warning track for out number two. I swear I'm going to find these home run stats for Texas Tech before this game is over. Here we go. So on the season, that's 37 home runs for Texas Tech. And Patty Gasso makes the cold walk towards the circle. Wyckoff's home run was her third of the season. The first inning home run from Villa was her sixth. Peyton Monticelli had been getting ready in the Sooner pen. Let's see if we're going to have a Love's Travel Stops pitching change. Love's Travel Stops is the heart of the highway. And Carly Keeney is going to get the call here. So, not a typical Kirsten Deal day based on what we've seen over the last couple of weeks, but still, 3 1/3. Allowed three hits, two runs, both of them earned. I mean, barring a comeback of biblical proportions, she's going to get her sixth win of the season. And the Sooners will turn to Carly Keeney out of the pen. Again, this pitching change is brought to you by Love's Travel Stops. Love's Travel Stops is the heart of the highway.
Number 8, Carly Keeney.
This game was pretty much decided in the first inning when the Sooners put a 12 spot on the board. And now they'll turn to the Providence, Kentucky native, graduate student out of, by way of, Liberty College, Carly Keeney, who after having a rough final inning against Louisiana Lafayette has been pretty fantastic. In an inning, she only allowed a hit, struck out two against Iowa State, against Tarleton State. Gave up two hits and a run. Had three strikeouts in that game, too. Keeney on the season, a 1.50 ERA, 28 innings. She's allowed 23 hits, 9 runs, but only 6 of them earned. 16 strikeouts to 7 walks. And of the 23 hits that she's allowed, 3 of those home runs, 5 extra base hits. So Carly Keeney takes over after the long fly ball. And here's Reagan Jennings. A couple hits this weekend for Jennings.
Batting for the Red Raiders, number 14, Reagan Jennings.
He's forced out at second base on the ground out by Abby Orrick. Here's the first pitch to Jennings. In for a strike from Carly Keeney. Hard-throwing righty. 65 on the gun. It's still pretty wild to look back, as painful as it is, on that Louisiana Lafayette game and how well she had played heading into that seventh inning. Here's a bouncer off the glove of Sanders to Hodge, who rolls it to Sanders covering the bag. Safe. That ball just got away from Sid Sanders. That will bring Abby Orrick to the plate. Interesting to see how that's ruled. Pretty sure that's an error, yeah. It's going to be E3, a rarity, an error on Sydney Sanders. Abby Orrick digs in from the right side of the plate. The first pitch Missed a little low, ball one. If there is anybody that
is... Red Raiders, number 11, Eddie Orr.
Oh, they checked with the first base umpire who said strike one. Keeney pointed to Ludlum to see if they could appeal it. They did, and Bubba Ewald over at first at strike one. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Strike two. Now the Boone family has checked in from Broken Arrow. Gala and Trevor are probably tired of hearing from me, that's for certain. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Carly Keeney threw it right by her. Two away. You want to hear just about how much Riley Boone means to Patty Gasso. Hopefully you heard our pregame show where we talked about the impact Boone has made as more than just a ball player. Matty Wright takes the first pitch that looked like strike one, a little bit in. Ball one. Wright was a strikeout victim her last time up. The only strikeout for Kirsten Deal. Here's the 1-0 from the righty Keeney. In for a strike, 1-1. It's Coke Zero Sugar, the best Coke ever. Take a taste. Find out for yourself. Coca-Cola, official partner of the Oklahoma Sooners. One on, two away. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Our bottom of the fourth inning, excuse me. It's like, let's go home. 12-2 Sooners. A 1-1 pitch is in for a strike. Oh, you bust down to Lubbock, so as soon as we wrap up tomorrow, bus trip back and get ready for a midweek against UTA. The 1-2, grounded softly to the right side. Up with it as Hodge throws to first, inning over. A leadoff home run and the first error of the weekend for the Sooners, but Keeney works around it. And as we head to that fifth inning, Oklahoma rolling. They lead Texas Tech 12-2. Maya Bland will lead things off in the fifth inning for the Sooners. Oklahoma 12, Texas Tech 2. Sooners haven't scored since the first. Maya Bland had a two-run double here last night. Sooners put 12 on the board in the first inning. Back to work for Mimi Blackledge. First pitch in for a strike to Maya Bland. Fifth innings this season are brought to you by the Hal Smith Restaurant Groups. Can't go wrong, honestly, with any of them. The 0-1 is a little bit up. Maya takes it. One ball, one strike. Learn more about all of the incredible restaurants at HalSmith.com. Bland grounds this one weakly towards the right side. The other games in the Big 12 are underway, the 2 o'clock starts. But we have one final from today. Iowa State falls to Houston 10-2, so the Cougars salvage one game of that series. After Iowa State smoked him yesterday. 1-2 misses low, two balls and two strikes. Pretty good bounce back, too, to have the struggles that Houston had had. To go out and put 10 runs on the board today. The 2-2 pitch misses just outside. The fans who have stayed true for the Texas Tech Red Raiders did not like that. Full count pitch to Maya Bland. Grounded again, foul to the right side. The other two games now were 2 o'clock starts. Baylor trying to force a rubber game. They lost yesterday to Kansas. The game is just underway in Lawrence. They're going to have some weather issues potentially this afternoon. Here's the 3-2 to Bland. Hard hit ball right side. Base hit. Maya Bland, the second baseman, Jennings, had shifted towards the first base bag a bit, and Bland hit it right where she was supposed to be. Maya Bland, get hot. Here's Jada Coleman. Quick update. Scoreless in Lawrence. They're in the top of the second inning. Kansas and Baylor. Oklahoma State out to an early 2-0 lead on UCF.
Number 24, Jada Coleman.
Texas already won its series from BYU. Here's Jada. First pitch up high, ball one. Jada's one for two on the day. Singled, walked, scored two runs, drove in a run. That walk came with the bases loaded. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Up high to him. A couple of things from the SEC. Georgia wins its series over Alabama, smoking the Tide today, 11-3. After rain didn't allow him to play yesterday in Starkville, A&M beat Mississippi State 9-0. 2-0 pitches, high ball three. Not saying I don't always trust D1Softball.com, but let's just double-check the box scores here real quick. Some of these scores have got us in the past. 9-0, A&M won today. 3-0 is in for a strike. And that is correct. 11-3, Georgia. Run-ruled Alabama. Here's the 3-1 pitch. Coleman takes ball four. A couple of other top 25 notes. Florida State forced a big game tomorrow with Duke. Florida State won 4-2. After getting trounced yesterday. Much tighter today in Knoxville for now. 2-1, Tennessee leads Missouri in the top of the fourth inning. A lot of good games later tonight. Ella Parker digs in, takes the first pitch low for ball one. One other note on that A&M-Mississippi State series. They'll play another game later tonight after they were washed out yesterday. Air Comfort Solutions brings you our scoreboard updates. First and second for the Sooners. Nobody out. The 1-0 pitch is in for a strike to Ella Parker. OU baseball later tonight against TCU. Push that game back. There's a lot of rain moving towards Fort Worth. The 1-1 is poked foul down the left field line. Kind of this front, this rainy, miserable front is moving through Texas. And it's headed your way, T-Row. Here's the 1-2. Hard hit ball to short, under the glove of Oric, in the left center field. Here comes Bland. She'll score. It's 13-2 Sooners on a rocket off the bat of Ella Parker. Here's Hannah Kaur. Oh, pretty sure they're going to give her a hit on that, even though probably a play that Oric would typically make. Coleman stands at third. Parker is at second. And here's Hannah Kaur's first at bat of the game, first plate
batting
appearance.
For the Sooners, number 27, Hannah Kaur.
First pitch. In for a strike. Boy, this has been a fun fifth inning. Sooners have been well in control on this one. Here's a hard hit ball deep to center field, racing back and making a leaping catch is Halliman. Coleman will tag and score. Hannah Kaur hit it on the butt, and it drives in the 15th run of the game on a sac fly RBI from Hannah Kaur. Here's Sid Sanders. Parker takes advantage of the opportunity and advances to third. Here's Sid. Sooners are really starting to get their timing here on Mimi Blackledge. If she comes close to the zone and Sanders, look out. Nearly hits her. In fact, they're going to say it did. Sid Sanders just launches the bat. He's 1-for-3 on the day, and now she'll head to first to put runners at the corners for T.R.A. Jennings. Sooner softball brought to you by Brahms Ice Cream and Dairy Stores. Farm fresh for over 50 years. And we'd like to thank Love's Travel Stops as the presenting sponsor of OU Softball. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. What a weekend for T.R.A. Jennings. First pitch, in for a strike. 2-for-2, with two RBI, a run scored, and a walk today. She was 3-for-3 last night. How about an 8th home run against Texas Tech in your career, T.R.A.? She takes a little off-speed low. Ooh, they called it a strike, 0-2. Parker at third, Sanders at first. Here comes the 0-2 pitch in the dirt. Saw our buddy Greg Scallion checked in, smoking beef ribs. We could eat those, Wondrosic, right? We could eat those. Gabby even smiled, Greg. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Hit hard but foul and out of play down the right field line. Red Leverage, it's 58 and sunny in New York City. But spending the afternoon indoors following Sooner softball. That is dedication, Red. It's just been a nasty weather front that's hit Lubbock this weekend, unfortunately. Here's the 1-2 to Tiare. She reaches and pokes this one deep to center field, and it's caught at the warning track by Holloman. Tagging and scoring is Ella Parker. It's a 3-RBI day on the sac fly. And Oklahoma is rolling in West Texas. 15-2 Sooners. Here's Alina Torres. Ground out to third in her last at bat. Sanders stayed at first. First pitch to Torres is in for a strike. Don't forget, next Friday night, 6 days, we are playing in Oklahoma City at Hall of Fame Stadium. There are tickets available. You better get them. Here's the 0-1. A little bit low and away, 1-1. I tell everyone that has ever either complained or asked about when can I get tickets, everything's sold out, this is it. This is your opportunity Friday night. Soonersports.com/tickets. Torres takes the 1-1, high 2-1. Baylor's good, too. And Kansas might be really good. Who knows? We'll see them in a couple weeks. That's the update on that game. They're still scoreless in the bottom of the second inning. 1-2 is a little bit out. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Hey, 15-2 Sooners. 12 hits. There's the 13th, a base hit back up the middle by Alina Torres. And that brings Riley Ludlam to the plate. I think every Sooner that has played today has contributed in some way. Every starter scored a run in the first inning. Hannah Kaur had the RBI, the sac fly. Maya Bland had the single and scored a run. Now there's a base hit for Torres. Here's a wild pitch to the backstop. Sanders is going to head to third. Torres will head to second. Everyone that has entered the game for the Sooners or stepped to the plate has either walked, got a base hit, or scored a run. Ludlam is the only player of the starters that doesn't have a hit, but she's walked twice. Here's the 1-0 pitch to Riley. Outside 2-0. Every Sooner starter has a hit. Oh, Brito. Brito walked once, and then Torres came in the game. 2-0. In for a strike, 2-1. A 12-run first. Sooners have tacked on three more here in the fifth. The pitch way up high, ball three. Avery Hodge waits on deck. Jada Coleman and Riley Boone are still standing on the top step leading the cheers for the Sooners, flanking hitting coach J.T. Gasso. It's the Lights shine. The 3-1 is ball four. The bases are loaded. And Avery Hodge becomes the ninth batter to hit this inning.
Batting for the Sooners, number 82.
Either the
Avery
sun
Hodge
is trying to peek through a bit through the crowd, or they've just kicked the lights on a little higher. First pitch to Hodge is inside. Lights have been on most of the day. It's by no means any warmer, but the precipitation and the weather issues have subsided for the most part. It's just chilly and damp conditions on the field. Here's the one ball, no strike pitch to Hodge. In for a strike. Avery singled and drove in a run in the first inning, scored, and has hit the ball twice hard. Lined out to short, lined out to left. That's here with the bases loaded and two outs, top of the fifth. The 1-1 pitch is in for a strike, one and two. Ludlam's at first, Torres is at second, Parker's at third. Naya Bland looking for her second at bat of the inning, waits on deck. The 1-2 is lifted pretty deep to center field, but Holloman races back and makes the catch short of the warning track, and that'll do it for the Sooners in the fifth. But Oklahoma adds three more runs, nearly bats around as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. Sooners three outs away from a series win. Oklahoma 15, Texas Tech 2. Back to work for Carly Keeney. Sooners up 15-2 after a three-run fifth inning. In the fifth innings that are brought to you by the Hal Smith Restaurant Groups. Logan Holloman, the nine-hole hitter, will lead things off. So Bland out and right. And the first pitch from Carly Keeney is a little bit out, ball one. Hannah Kaur in center, or in left, Jada Coleman in center, Bland in right, in the infield of Torres at third, Tiari at short, Hodge at second, and Sanders at first. And Carly Keeney in the circle, who relieved Kirsten Deal. There's an attempt at the bunt by Holloman, who's 0-for-1. I got an update on Friday night, guys. There's less than 1,000 tickets left. Soonersports.com/tickets. OU playing Baylor at Hall of Fame Stadium. Here's the 1-1 pitch up high. It'd be really cool to have the two largest regular season crowds in college softball history. And then it'd be really, really cool to break it with an in-state opponent like Tulsa in a midweek in a couple weeks. 2-1. Ooh, that just missed outside. Three balls and a strike. Fifteen runs on 13 hits for the Sooners. Just unbelievable. There's a hard hit ball to short. Jennings takes a couple steps back, gloves it, throws one away. The speedy Holloman is retired. She'll finish the 0-for-2. Here's Aubrey Barnhart. We'll start the Sooner postgame show as soon as the last out is registered here. Lot to get to today. Lot to get to. We'll get ready for the series finale tomorrow. Here's the first pitch to the left-handed hitting Barnhart. Tries to turn on a pitch, turn away from a pitch on the inside corner and takes strike one. No balls and a strike. Grounded foul on the 0-1 pitch. They announced last night's attendance at 1,056. In the history of Rocky Johnson Field, the Sooners have four of the top seven crowds ever, but weather kind of kept that number down last night. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Barnhart. Swing and a miss. Two away. Ariana Villa, who homered in the first inning, is the last hope here for Texas Tech.
Batting for the Red Raiders, number 00, Ariana Villa.
Keeney's been pretty good since she came in. Here's the first pitch from the right-handed throwing Keeney to the left-handed hitting Villa, and it's a little bit up and away, ball one. Sooners pounced early. Never looked back. Here's the 1-0 pitch from Keeney. Popped foul down the left field line. Is there room for Corno? Texas Tech hasn't had an at-bat with a runner in scoring position today. Oklahoma is 8-for-11. It's a pretty good scout in my book, I'm just saying. 7.27 average with runners in scoring position. 1-1 fouled off the foot of Villa. Ouch. And Tech is down to its last strike as Oklahoma looks to win the series. One ball, two strikes. Here we go, the pitch. Just a little in. Just a little in, 2-2. The Sooner fans here clap in unison. The pitch. Oh, man. Where did that miss? 3-2. Maybe a skosh low, but come on. Aren't you cold? Don't you want to go home? Three balls and two strikes to the left-handed hitting Villa. Keeney gets the ground ball to the right side. Hodge gloves it, throws to first. Ball game. Oklahoma puts a 12 spot on the board in the first inning. And run rules Texas Tech by a final score of 15-2 to take the series in Lubbock. They'll go for the sweep tomorrow at nooon. Oklahoma, 26-1 on the season, 5-0 in Big 12 play. Final score in run rule fashion, Oklahoma 15, Texas Tech 2.